Today we will be talking about a recap of what happened in sports and what's coming up. Hi, I'm Michael Wright. I'm here with
Deborah Millier.
And we have a special guest with
Alan Gilchrist.
Today we'll first be talking about wrestling, and the men's wrestling won against Coker 30-9. And then upcoming, they will have traveling to King on the 31st, but also a big win at Truett Invitational against Truett and Allen. The women hosted the Robert Ord opening, and next they will be hosting the Presbyterian tonight at 6 o'clock. Then they will be traveling to a national championship against King on the 31st. Next, in men's basketball, they had a win over Urshan at home, where they beat both encounters with them this season. And would you like to expand on that?
They had a nice big win at Belmont Abbey. They continue to have wins, and we are looking forward to their next game. They are currently tied in the overall standings, 9-3, and they will be hosting Tuan next.
With another win against, with women's basketball, they had a great win against Urshan as well. They also beat them twice this season. And after bouncing back against Belmont Abbey after a tough loss, the ladies are fourth overall behind Francis Marion, UNC Prep, and Belmont Abbey. And they will also host Shawan this week. With men's volleyball, they're playing against Fort Valley State back-to-back with a huge win, huge great home win this past week. Now they will be traveling to Fort Valley on the 31st. They may have won both matches this season so far, but let's hope they can continue on. Next, we have track and field. And would you like to talk about what
they're doing? Sure. They competed well at the Crossplex in Birmingham, Alabama. Mason, he's a freshman. He did shot put, did an excellent job, 13.94. He's fourth in the conference currently. Matthew had a personal record of 2.01 minutes in the 800 meter run. Brandon was a second away from the school record. He was first in the conference. And Maddie also had a personal record, second in the conference, of 1.55 in the high jump. And the women 4x4 are currently standing in fifth position in the conference. So they're doing very well. I know the women have a meet up this Saturday as well. Hopefully they will continue to make personal records and break other conference records.
And upcoming for the men's lacrosse team, they'll be traveling to UGA for their first invite for the season. Next, we'll have bowling, which they'll be traveling to
SCAD. They're
SCAD.
Heading to SCAD at, for the B-Bash. They'll be having fun down there with their bowling.
Next, we have tennis. They have an opening spring season at UNC Nashville, and they will also be traveling to Mercer the next day. Next, we have swimming. How you doing, Coach?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. Would you like to do a recap of the season and so far how the season has went for you guys?
Sure, absolutely. So we're in our championship segment of the season with conference champs coming up in February. March. So far this season, our men are 10-1, and our women are 11-1. And we had a fantastic December. We had swimmers literally swimming around the world during their break. We had here at home in the U.S., we had May at the Paralympic National Championships, where she was a national champion in the 100 breast. And earlier in the month, she had set an American record in the 50 breaststroke. So that was our first national champion in December. Our second national champion was Bartosz in Poland. He had 8 best times at his Polish national championships and was a national champion as a member of the 400 medley relay. That was our second national champion on another continent over in Europe. And then we had a third national champion. It was Valentina in Bolivia. She was actually a five-time national champion. She is a senior captain, so we're going to miss her greatly. But she's got a few meets to go. But she was our third national champion. We also had Susana Ungo in Spain, who won a 3,000-meter swim. And then finally, we had four girls who went down to Miami, Florida in late December for the Collegiate Open Water Nationals 5K swimming, so a 3.1-mile swim. And our women's team finished second overall as a team at the national championships. And they missed first by 1.43 seconds. And you think about how each of them swam for an hour and 3 minutes, and you combine those times, it was this close to getting first place. But a lot of great things happening with our team last semester in the month of December, and now we're just looking forward to finishing out the season strong.
So would you say you're pretty confident going to the Conference Carolina Championship for both men and women?
Yes, we both won last year, so we're defending conference champions. The men won by quite a bit last year, about 300 points, so we're very confident that they're going to win again this year. We've got a strong freshman class to back that up. But the women last year, they won by 6 points, which means it came down to the last event on the fourth day of the meet. But we're a lot more confident this year that we're going to win by more points and not have to worry about that last moment on the relay, because we've got a strong freshman class and a strong, probably our strongest women's team. And so we're really focused on trying to make as many school records, meet records, conference records, and national cuts as we can. That's really our big focus. And we'll try to get our hand